You want to customize the look of your YouTube channel homepage, but how do you even do that? In today's video, I'm going to show you how and give you some tips on how you can customize your YouTube channel homepage to attract more subscribers. Hey guys, my name is Trena and welcome to another episode of Just the Tips. If this is your first time here on my channel and you want to learn more about how to use YouTube video in your business strategy, make sure you click that red subscribe button down below so you don't miss out. Like I said, in today's video, I'm going to show you how to customize the homepage of your YouTube channel. And you'll want to make sure you stay until the end because I'm going to be sharing my three must-dos for your customization of your homepage. Before we jump on over to my computer so I can show you exactly how to do this, let me know in the comments below if you've customized your YouTube homepage or if you plan to customize it after this video. Let me know. This is what your YouTube channel would look like if you have not customized the layout of your channel. As you see here, it just basically lists my activities, or it could be organized by most recent post. But even then, it's just listing my videos. It's not very organized. People would have to scan through here to find the content they're looking for. And it just doesn't look very professional. So what you want to do is go over to the cogwheel, this cogwheel right here, right beside the subscribe button, click on it, and then go over here to customize the layout of your channel. Make sure this switch is turned on, and then save. Now your channel should be set up for customization. So the next thing you want to do is start creating playlists and organizing your videos into groups of videos that's easier for people to find.
Okay, so what are the top three things that you should customize on your homepage? First, make sure you always add your social media links to your channel banner and make that first link your opt-in because it's so important for your YouTube channel to act as a way to grow your email list. And by having your opt-in as that first link, it's the biggest link and you can put the most text there. Second, make sure you have a channel banner and make sure in that channel banner you have your value proposition. So make sure it's very clear on your channel banner exactly what value you're bringing your subscribers. This way, when someone comes to your channel, they'll know instantly what to expect from your channel and they'll know whether or not they want to subscribe or not. And third, start creating playlists to organize all your content. So if you're just starting out and you don't have any content yet, that's fine. But once you start creating some content, start organizing your homepage by using playlists. It allows people to quickly see what you have to offer on your YouTube channel and the exact information they're looking for from you. Not only does creating playlists make your channel just look more visibly appealing, but it allows people to see exactly what kind of content you provide, and it allows them to see exactly the content they're looking for from you. Make sure you grab my YouTube channel checklist. I'm going to walk you through 10 steps to ensure your channel is set up for success. So grab that download by clicking right here. And if you want more YouTube tutorials like this video, make sure you give this video a thumbs up. And finally, I want to throw a shout out to one of my VIP Patreon members this week, Sonalia. If you want to learn more about Sonalia and how you can be featured on my YouTube channel like this, make sure you check out the description box below with all the information. And if you want to learn how to use YouTube in your business strategy, make sure you click that little circle subscriber button right there, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye!